With Update 2, Jurassic World Evolution 2 is looking better than it ever has before. We've had a raft of new decorations, including my personal favourite, Crane. We got the first person mode, we got the species viewer, and of course, the Jurassic Park 3 female Velociraptor finally had her eye colour fixed. The game is finally getting to where it maybe should have been at launch, but where does it go from here? What does the future of Jurassic World Evolution 2 look like? What kind of DLCs can we expect? How long are they going to take to arrive? How long is the game going to be supported for? And what does the game really need to elevate it even further above its predecessor? We're going to go through all of that in this video. Let me know your thoughts and comments down below. And also let me know whether you eat the skin on a kiwi, because I do eat the skin on a kiwi, but everyone thinks it's super weird. So I'd like to feel a little bit vindicated, please. Thanks. First of all then, what does the future for Evolution 2 actually look like? What is Frontier's support plan for the game likely to be? If you think back to the first game we heard, I don't know if it was ever directly quoted, but we definitely heard rumours and suggestions that the game was going to be supported for about 2 years. In the end, it didn't quite manage that. It's actually about 18 months between the first release and the final DLC. What Evolution 1 did get was a ton of great free updates coinciding with the release of 7 different DLC packs, if you exclude the Deluxe Dinosaur Pack that of course came with the release of the game, essentially. These 7 DLCs consisted of 3 big story DLCs, that was first of all Secrets of Dr. Wu, Claire's Sanctuary, and then Return to Jurassic Park. We also had 3 dinosaur packs, the Herbivore Pack, the Cretaceous Pack, and the Carnivore Pack. And then we had the Raptor Squad skin pack thingamajiggy, which is kind of more like the, you know, the Skyrim horse armor of this game, if we're totally honest. So we'll kind of push that to the side. There were 6 major DLCs for Jurassic World Evolution. Now, there have been suggestions already that Evolution 2 might be aiming a little bit higher, aiming for around 10 or so DLCs. Now, we've had 2 of those already. Of course, we've had the early Cretaceous pack first, and just earlier this month, we had the Camp Cretaceous Dinosaur Pack. Does that mean we have 8 more DLCs left to go? That would be quite a nice long support for the game. Are we ever going to see a cow in Jurassic World Evolution 2? That's very high on my personal list. We're going to have to wait and see on that regard, but given the high quality of the free updates so far, and that really is something Frontier have been fantastic about for both games, it looks like the future of the game is very healthy at least, and there's a lot of exciting things still to come. But we'll dig into that more in just a little bit. What about the timeline then? When are we likely to get more DLC? How long is this going to take? Well, Jurassic World Evolution 2 released on the 9th of November last year, 2021. The early Cretaceous pack released exactly 1 month later on the 9th of December 2021, and then it was about a 3 month sans 1 day gap to the 8th of March 2022 for the Camp Cretaceous Dinosaur Pack. Now that 3 month gap that we just had is probably going to be the norm going forward. The early Cretaceous pack can come out a little bit earlier because when a game is completed, you know, it's been generally finished, it's gone through quality assurance, it's then getting pressed into the discs and it's being sent out and marketing has to be done, all this kind of stuff. At that point, the animators, the modelers, the sound design people, the texture artists, everyone who is working on the game, probably the programmers, yada yada yada, they're probably just about done with the actual main game. They've got less to do. You'd keep a few behind, but they can actually get started on the next DLC, which is why the first DLC for a game tends to come out before all the others. It tends to be a lot quicker in terms of its release schedule, just because it means the devs aren't just wasting their time sitting around doing nothing whilst the game goes through marketing, etc, etc. If you look back at the first game, that would make a lot of sense. That's the kind of timeline that the first game worked with. Secrets of Dr. Wu actually came out 5 months, however, after the release of the game. Of course, we had the Fallen Kingdom pack in the meantime. Claire's Sanctuary had a 4 month gap, and the final story DLC, Return to Jurassic Park, had a 3 month gap. So the story DLCs did take a little longer on average, and then the dinosaur packs brought that average back down. Now that timeline does actually work really well with Jurassic World Evolution 2 as well. We've had our 1 month for that first DLC just to get something out there, kind of like the Fallen Kingdom pack for the first game. Then we've had a 3 month wait, as you would expect, for the next DLC. And then what's in 3 months time? It's Jurassic World Dominion, nearly 3 months to the day after the release of the Camp Cretaceous Dinosaur Pack. That came out on the 8th of March. Jurassic World Dominion is slated to come out on the 10th of June in the US. Some suggestions it may be a little earlier in some countries. I think here in the UK we may actually get hold of it earlier than the 10th, but we'll have to wait and see how that plays out. But the point is, it is basically exactly 3 months. It really fits their timeline very well. And I would expect this to be the biggest DLC and at least the biggest free update they've ever done, surpassing the Fallen Kingdom update, which is obviously the past equivalent, that had 6 dinosaurs in it. Now, a lot of Fallen Kingdom dinosaurs were already in the game, but the Dominion update, it's got a lot more dinosaurs to fit in there, so I'd expect a big, big, big update and DLC. Given the huge size of a potential Dominion update, I don't expect it all to be a free update, we should say that right now. Probably contains over 12, 13, 14 plus dinosaurs, if you include the variants and stuff like that. If you think back to, say, Dreadnoughtus, of course we'd want a new prologue-based version. I'd expect quite a lot of it to be free, akin to the Fallen Kingdom update, but in that case, I'd expect it to be more the main dinosaurs, maybe your Atrociraptors and things like that would probably be part of the free update. And if I had to guess the story components, let's say a new Chaos Theory, maybe some new campaign levels, because it did feel a little incomplete, maybe they are part of the paid DLC, and then maybe the prologue dinosaurs are part of a paid pack or something like that. You'd expect the big heavy hitter dinosaurs from the film to be free, but I'm expecting a paid component, so I just suggest preparing yourselves for that now. For what it's worth, 10 pieces of DLC, if that's what we get, on a 3-month per DLC timeline would give us about 2.5 years of support, maybe a little bit lower, because of course that first DLC came out relatively quickly. So 2 to 2.5 years, which I think is probably around about where Frontier wants to aim for this game. It's not their own title, it's a franchise game, you know, it's not a Planet Coaster, it's not a Planet Zoo. Now, the hope is that by the end of that 2 year or so timeline, the game is as good as it possibly can be, and we'll talk more about that in just a moment. This is likely, there's not going to be a Jurassic World Evolution 3, right? It seems very unlikely. So this is likely to be the last big Jurassic Park builder we get for a very long time. There's other games, of course, like Prehistoric Kingdom taking up the slack, but we're not going to get much else for a while, I would suggest. So this has to be a game that lasts us a long time. Remember how long JPOG had to last? JPOG was all we had for so, so long. It could be the same again. So we need Evolution 2 to be absolutely tippity-top if it's going to inspire and carry us through more generations of gamers. Assuming then that the DLCs follow the same rough sort of style as the first game, I would suggest if we're going to have 10 of them, maybe 6 or 7 of them will be dinosaur packs, and then 3 or 4 of them would be story DLCs. You'd expect the story DLCs to be less common than the dinosaur packs. That's actually not how it ended up on the first game. By the end, it was the 3-3 split, and then we of course had the Raptor Squad skin pack. But you'd expect the story packs to be a little bit less common, maybe 1 a year. Maybe we'll get 2022, 2023, and then maybe 1 at the start of 24 or at the very end of 23 is kind of like the capper to the whole thing, if I had to guess. So then one thing I am curious about, and I'd love some thoughts and opinions on, not just the Kiwis, but what would a story DLC for Jurassic World Evolution 2 look like? If we think back to the first game, we had Secrets of Dr. Wu and we had Claire's Sanctuary. They both took existing storylines within Fallen Kingdom and kind of expanded on them a little bit. It's kind of like a what-if scenario, especially for Claire's Sanctuary. Return to Jurassic Park was, of course, just a big old ball of nostalgia bait, lovely stuff. And that's about it for the first game. So what would the second game do? We've got Jurassic World Dominion. Now let's assume the first story is something, just reenacting some scenes from Jurassic World Dominion of some form. They've got a lot more potential now, a lot more possibility, of course. We've got all these biomes around the world. The games can go near enough absolutely anywhere. What else could we see? How are they going to integrate Jurassic World Dominion into these story-based DLCs? I'd love to hear your thoughts and suggestions on that, because I've been racking my brain and there's not many there right now. Maybe that says more about my brain than anything else, I don't know. I had some ideas though. For example, I'd expect an introduction to Biosyn, maybe a Biosyn-focused DLC, maybe another Wu-focused DLC and his interactions with Biosyn as well. Maybe a new Frozen map we've seen a few times. I'm trying not to give away film spoilers here. Even a certain forest we see with some certain effects going on towards the end. You know, that could be a really cool map to play on. Maybe, I think we're going to see a lot of these what-if scenarios. Maybe like you take the Chaos Theory and you expand on it even further. One thing I'd love to see personally is Return to Isla Sauna or something like that. Take Return to Jurassic Park but apply it to Jurassic Park 2, Jurassic Park 3. It'd be hard to give us new dinosaurs and stuff based on that, but in terms of story potential, basically I just want Paul Kirby to be in the game, alright? If they could get William H. Macy to be in the game, I would actually die happy, so All that said, what does the game actually still need? So we've got all these DLCs and inevitably fantastic free updates coming along with these DLCs. But what do we actually need these updates to contain? And this gets harder and harder to answer with time. There's several drums I've been, I can't help my hands, okay? They do their own thing. There's several drums I've been beating for years now. Peter Path, that's now in the game. Blessed Peter Path, Blessed P4 Path, I can't speak English. First person mode is something I've been asking for years and years and years, and it's in the game. Scientists are gone. We've near enough got instant incubation and stuff like that. It's not quite instant, but it's instant enough. Again, more things we wanted. What else is there? There's not that much left. There's just some little things here and there we need now. Let's talk about that a little bit more. The biggest one for me and the longest, this drum has been beaten for a long time. It's now sturdy and rigid and doesn't sound great, but we still have to keep beating it. We need more attractions. That is priority numero uno. Imagine a big one here. Actually, through the magic of editing, I could put one there. We need more attractions. It is the one thing I think holding the game back in some regards, especially when it comes to building a proper Jurassic World, a proper park, something that feels like a Jurassic Park or Jurassic World, rather than a zoo, rather than a tour, rather than a viewing gallery. You know, it has to have more attractions, and that means two different things. That means both viewing areas, so we're talking things like the balloon tour, which is kind of a viewing guide, or the viewing tunnels, again, from JPOG, or the T-Rex tunnel, the T-Rex log thing from Jurassic World, or something about the Indominus paddock, or the canoe ride, or the petting zoo thingamajiggy, or like a high tide kind of thing from the film to view your sauropods up close. Just things like that, ways to view your dinosaurs. And then beyond that, attractions like roller coasters and other general park sort of things, which I think is something the game really struggles with, is feeling like a park. The roller coasters wouldn't have to be custom made, you know, we could do it like the monorail, that'd be really cool, but I don't expect the game to go that far. Even if it is just you place it down, it takes up a bunch of space, and people go and ride it, that would work for me. If we could get the Bone Crusher, is that what it's called? It's been so long. I think it's called the Bone Crusher. If we get that roller coaster in, that'd be really, really cool. And I think that's the next step the game really needs to take in order to give it that long-term sustainability. The last thing is simply a little bit more love for the lagoons. They do seem a little bit basic now in comparison to the aviaries. The aviaries have tours that go through them. And of course, we've got the new sticks. Nesting spots, roosting spots, things, poles, stick poles. We've got those. And of course, you can decorate the terrain. You can make your own terrain and do all that kind of stuff. And the lagoons just have nothing. And unfortunately, it does make the aquatic creatures seem a little bit boring in comparison, because they just don't have anything to do and there's no way to decorate their environment. At the very least, what I mean, personally, I'd love like a tour, like a submarine tour, you know, like in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, or an underwater tunnel or something, or just more ways for guests to interact with the lagoon would be really cool. But if not that, then at least the ability to edit the terrain in the lagoon would be a big deal. Whoa, I just punched everything. Just let us, you know, put plants, even if you're going to limit the type of plants, you know, give us a handful of aquatic plants and some rocks and just let us decorate the base of the lagoon. It wouldn't be much, and we do need more than that, I think, but it would be a step in the right direction. They just lack customizability and they're a little bit on the boring side, so I'd love to see them get a little bit of love as well. And also, while we're on the topic, if we could make the water less murky, that would be brilliant. It's really hard to see your creatures. It's really annoying. You go down in the viewing gallery and you can't see a bloody thing. There's just no point. So hopefully that's something we can get fixed as well. Other than that, I don't actually see much room for improvement. People will always go on about baby dinosaurs. I totally understand why people want baby dinosaurs. I think it's a pipe dream. I think if it wasn't going to be out at release, it's never going to happen now, and it's just never going to happen. You'll have to stick with the mods for that one. But beyond that, is there much else out there? Keep punching everything. Let me know your thoughts down below. Let me know your comments down below. What else do you want to see in the game? I'm particularly interested in your thoughts on the story expansions, because I've been, as I say, racking my brain and I'm not quite sure. I think we'll have to see Dominion first to have a real good idea of what those could look like. But I'm very curious. What do you want to see for Jurassic World Evolution 2? What does the final game look like to you? What DLCs would you be most excited about? What most needs improving? All that kind of jazz. I think that's about it. Oh, and the Kiwi skin. More importantly than anything, Kiwi skin. That's about it from me. Thank you very much for joining me. If you enjoyed the video, please do throw me a like down below, subscribe to the channel, all that, you know, general YouTube nonsense. This is the first time I've done this. It's very disconcerting. Yeah, I'm not sure how I feel about it. I may record this entire video and then go, you know what? Yeah, done. Bye. But we'll see what happens. Thank you for joining me. Cheers. Much love, as always. Bye-bye.